All right, hey folks, Emily here. So today you are gonna learn how to customize your own foundation models using Amazon SageMaker. So let's get started. So you'll see here, I have SageMaker Studio up. Previously, we learned about how to deploy foundation models on SageMaker using SageMaker Jumpstart. We did a quick tour through pre-training, and now we're gonna learn about customizing foundation models. So generally, you can customize foundation models with prompt engineering, with fine-tuning, with retrieval augmented generation, and evaluating models is really helpful. So I wanted to show you how to evaluate a model really briefly. So in SageMaker Studio, you can navigate down to model evaluation. Within model evaluation, you can select create a model evaluation. You'll just enter in a job name, such as evaluates. And then essentially there are two options for you. You can do automatic evaluation, which uses pre-built algorithms. You can also set up a human evaluation job. For both of these, you can add a model to this. So you can add a Llama 2 chat model, such as this one, and then select and continue. And so essentially you'll create this job, run the job, and then the evaluation shows up in your page. You can also fine tune a model. So let's take a look at that. In the models for SageMaker Jumpstart, you'll see we have many options. So let's take a look at the Llama base models. So again, Llama 2, 7B chats. Let's look at this, and then we can train this model. So we'll click train, and then we'll point to the example data set. You'll note we can set any hyperparameters as necessary. We can pick the training instance. The security settings are available to modify as necessary, and then we can just hit submit. We'll accept the EULA, and then our job is up and running. Fortunately, I already have an example job for you. And so this is the completed run for this job. I can deploy this model and then test inference for it. I can see the performance results, the configurations, the instances, the hyperparameters. And that is how to very quickly get started with customizing a foundation model using Amazon SageMaker. So in the next video, we are gonna take a look at deploying models using SageMaker. Thanks.